we wanted to make him a little bigger if possible, but in the end, I think that where we ended up is about as big as you can get without it becoming completely unwieldy and unusable. So it's right now at the point where it is effective as a performer inside the suit, and it's not too big that you're sort of disconnected from it. You know, we still have to feel a connection in the physical world, and that was the whole conceit from the beginning. It seems to me that, you know, there are directors who embrace physical effects because they understand them, they know what they are and how they're supposed to work, and they also like the fact that the practical effect is a tactile presence on the set. You know, it helps the other actors to perform against this thing, and it also, it's a presence, you know, it's a real entity that is standing right in front of the camera without any question, you know. With CG, sometimes there's this subconscious disconnect. The way that Edward breaks down is we have one person operating his eyes and his brows and the area around his eyes, one person operating all of his mouth movement, his jaw opening and closing, the jaw that moves, you know, that's multi-axial jaw, and all the lip movement, including a tongue inside the mouth. That's the second person. And then there's one person each on each of his hands to operate the animatronic hands. And that's how the workload breaks down. It's very difficult. You have to be in tremendous condition, a great athlete, to be able to negotiate just wearing the suit, let alone performing, you know, and having a performance come through all of those layers of material that are in front of you to convey, you know, subtle emotions, you know, and to convey any number of things that the director's asking him to do. With Tommy coming to my studio and the two of us sitting down and talking about what Muriel was going to look like, we created a look, you know, a sort of an idea that she would have cracks in her face and she would be, you know, pale, ashen, you know, and just a really sort of almost the statue that came to life kind of, you know, look. Initially, nobody likes the process. I mean, you're having rubber glued to your face and, you know, paint put around your eyes, and it's not happy time, you know. But what I've always noticed is that after that first application, you know, before the actor comes out of the chair, as they're standing up to look at themselves in the mirror, there's a change, and you see it. It's immediate. And when they see themselves as the character completely, all of a sudden they forget about the sensory stuff that's going on, and they look at this entity that's staring back at them from the mirror, who's not them, but it is them. It's a pretty cool moment.